All right, welcome back to Brotoman Gaming, and I think Drake is almost let loose. We're just gonna... Oh, that missile almost hit us. We're just gonna keep an eye on Drake here, because he got the jump on us last time. But, yeah, getting past those guys and those missiles is not easy. I remembered it being, like, one of the easiest missions. But, you gotta just keep going back and forth and back and... Okay, that definitely have to... Okay, where is that fucker? Okay, I see his rockets. Oh, Jesus. I just blew that one up in your face, dude. Oh, God! I'm nervous, but at least we can jump. Alright, let's let this cool down. Oh! Whoa! That would have been the death of us now. I don't like this. Dude, he's taking these lasers. At least he's got a reload. Is he out of rockets? Okay. He's like, I thought this would be enough rockets. I'm sorry. There we go! That has to, yeah. Woo! I was nervous. One rocket would have been the best of us. Woo! Alright, I'm done fucking around in space. Oh, actually, let me fix this. Yeah, that might be a little better. Oh, and James Bond's the martini.
Or is it stirred, not shaken?
Definitely stirred.
Definitely stirred.
It's shaking!
Astronomers from around the globe are reporting unexpected meteor showers. Well done, 007.
But I'm sure the world won't mind my taking a few days off. We'll let the autopilot be our designated driver.
I don't know if that's a good idea. Have you heard about the Teslas? It just drives them into... Well, it is driving them into a fucking water. Oh, what a climax. Silver? What did we need to get? We dispatched 32! Our accuracy was terrible. Our health remaining was terrible. And I feel like if we would have beaten that in like 10 more seconds, we would have gotten the gold. And also, something that I was going to say last time, there are no Bond moves in this level at all. Which I thought there might have been one involving the satellite so you could get it to stop shooting lasers, but no. Alright, and let's scroll through the credits, I guess. And I'm not gonna make this a super... Oh, okay. We got James Bond card. You gotta love that. The multiplayer scenario, GoldenEye. GoldenEye Strike, I guess. And I forget what... Yeah, you get to see the behind the scenes. It's so weird. Pierce Brosnan did all this stuff for the game, but he didn't do the voice.
For over 20 months, the team at EA Games developed James Bond 007 Nightfire.
I really do like this credits, too. You get to see all the stuff, like the little scenery they made, the little guns they used, the pianos. It's cool, man.
Collaborated to create an
the eyebrow raise.
James Bond experience. Adding to the fantasy.
Oh, man. This is definitely a top 10 game of all time for me. It is so classic.
Thanks in part to a laser.
I play this game like every... Oh, tweak the eyebrows. Do the eyebrow tweak. That's what we want to see. It is just so great for me. It's got so much nostalgia for me. The multiplayer's insane.
We see Pierce Brosnan in the game. You see Pierce Brosnan. He's the epitome of James Bond. Debonair, suave, charismatic. Came out great. And I think he brings a certain authenticity and personality to the character just like he does in the film. So when you see him weep...
Yeah, I would just... That would be me all day just tweaking the eyebrows up and down.
Fast cars are another part.
I bet they went at one point like, hey, look, we got the eyebrows super high. It's even off his face.
The Vanquish, also featured in this year's Bond film Die Another Day, sports a 6
Die Another Day, yeah, that was the film that they just kind of did an original Bond film based off of.
5 seconds and reach speeds in excess of 190 miles per hour.
I feel like every James Bond film now has Vanquish.
To bring this amazing vehicle into the game, the design team at EA worked
with playing with the little toy cars. Oh my god, this is a really in-depth behind the scenes as well.
3D mesh in the digital realm. From fast cars to beautiful women and exotic locations, James Bond 007 Nightfire is packed with all the elements that make it classic James Bond, allowing the player to live out the fantasy of the world's best secret agent.
Nightfire. Now the real credits. I mean, these are going to be some decently long credits, I think, so I'll just talk, I guess, about why I like this game so much. This game, it feels, I've talked about it a couple times, but it legit feels like you're playing a movie. You start in, you know, the exotic location, Paris. You pick up one pretty woman who becomes your little, what are you called? I don't want to say accomplice, but who becomes your Bond girl. That's kind of the term, Bond lady, throughout the first half of the mission. And then you figure out what's going on. You kind of spy in that first little snowy mission. And you go from town to town, city to city, all over the world, until halfway through the game on that sniping mission slash the submarine mission, you're just like, whoa. This guy has got some crazy shit. We need to stop this. But until then, you're just still kind of snooping around, and then it takes a kind of turn. It's an interesting game. I'm obviously heavily biased. I've been playing this game for freaking 20 years. And I mean, anything that you've been playing slash doing for 20 years, you're gonna be super biased towards. So, I don't know, but if I had... I was gonna say make the game a little longer, but it's plenty long, you know? I feel like it's almost in that perfect length. Maybe add one more level, but like, it ends on such a perfect note. That little base that's impossible, and then going into space. And the levels before that too are great, where you're just on the island. Oh. Like, maybe one on foot level on the island. That would be my one thing. Maybe one on foot level. But then it would feel too much like Far... I don't know. It would feel too much like Far Cry, I guess, would be my thing. It would feel kind of out of place. I don't know. I'm just shooting out suggestions. You could also play Jungle in GoldenEye if you want that experience. And I'm trying to think. I think this was the first James Bond game with an original song. I've beaten Agent Under Fire, the game before this, like, three times. I think it just uses, like, the little James Bond theme. And it is not nearly as good-looking as this. I mean, it's got a decent story, and the story continues in this game. So, I mean, yeah, that's kind of cool that they do kind of a continuation thing. But the gameplay, graphics... story are all better in Nightfire than they are in Agent Under Fire. And then, the multiplayer mode, again, obviously is better in Nightfire than Agent Under Fire, because, you know, they do have the bots in Agent Under Fire, but I think, like, only up to four, so, like, if you're playing with three players, you can only have one bot. If you're playing with four players, you can have zero bots. Whereas Nightfire, you can have, like, six bots no matter what. So they definitely improved upon that. And then the next game, I believe, is Die Another Day, Everything or Nothing, I think so. It's like a two-player co-op game. Like the story's co-op. It's pretty interesting. It's all original. And it's third person, not first person. That one, I don't even know if I beat, to be honest, because by that time I was kind of not falling out of James Bond games. Like, I'll always have love for James Bond games, but, you know, they were kind of stacking them in the mid-aughts. They were almost releasing them yearly. And kind of after From Russia With Love, I was like, okay, I'm going to take a break from this for a while. Not that From Russia With Love wasn't good. It was great. But, you know, I did buy Diet... Oh, my God. Everything or Nothing. I always get those two mixed up because I swear the box art and the, like, movie cover art looks identical. I did buy Everything or Nothing. It's just, I don't know. It doesn't feel the same to me. It feels very on track when you're in the story mode. And it doesn't have the bots. The bots was always my main thing in Nightfire. Because there could be so much chaos in multiplayer. And one thing that I don't know if I've mentioned yet is on the consoles, PS2, Xbox, GameCube, the story mode is all completely the same. Game Boy, it's kind of a weird port of the, console version. PC, the story is completely different. I mean, the story is kind of the same, but also, it is, like, all the levels are different. It's pretty cool. I've never played the PC version. I want to one day. I've never really had a good enough PC in the past 15 years. I probably had a good enough one when it came out, but I was playing it on consoles. Tear it down. I want to play it one day. It definitely seems like it could be really interesting. I've looked at footage of it, and it looks a lot different. A lot different. And in fact, in the guide that I have, which is the Prima guide, because I forget, they used to make, like, two guides back in the day. Maybe even three. I think they made Prima, Nintendo Game Guides, and maybe OXM. Something like that. I definitely know they made two for sure, and then those two big ones merged. But anyway, in the guide I have, it's like, it goes console walkthrough, the first half of the guide, and then PC walkthrough, the second half of the guide. It's pretty weird. And my God, these credits are long. I, like, beat the mission in, like, a minute, and then the credits are going on for 10. But, you know, I wonder if there's a picture of just that background. That's, like, I kind of would make that my phone background, or PC background right now. Just all those characters. Tear it down. Solvers? Is that, like, the people that actually solved the level? I've never heard that term. Motion capture, is that Pierce? They didn't put Pierce on motion capture! Also, I definitely have my next GameCube game I'm going through. I don't want to say it yet, I just kind of want to put it out there. But, it's going to be a good one. It's going to be a good one. I think people will be happy with it. MGM got their credits in here. Yeah, I shouldn't have been worried about not hearing a song. We're just hearing this shit loop. Sometimes you'll recognize names, but I guess, I was going to say I'm not recognizing any of these, but I guess it is also 20 years after the fact. So even if it was like their first project, you know, when they were like 25, they'd be fucking 45 by now. Oh, we're on to the special thanks. Special thanks to Aston Martin Limited Edition. I was going to say that's the car he always uses, not the Vanquish, the Aston Martin. The Biggie Stock Group. I want to see special thanks to you. That's always the best. God, they got a lot of special thanks out here. I want to see if there's anyone random. Like any celebrity special thanks. Special thanks to Arnold Schwarzenegger or some shit. Seems probably all family. All the Euro special thanks got a lot less people. They're like, no, we already thanked too many people. You guys get like 5. Just do what are you called? Heads up, 7-Up, or Thumb Wars. James Bond will return. He's always returning. Although it doesn't name the game. I think in Agent Under Fire, it actually named the game. Not sure. And we crashed your console. No. All right. But I don't want to leave it like that, just 2 minutes of gameplay. So I actually do want to show off a little bit of multiplayer here. I mean, I should know, but I don't know which people I have. I know I have Y-Lin. Phoenix Base. Phoenix, these are the two best ones right here. Phoenix Base and Snowblind. What was I gonna say? This one, weirdly enough, you can't use bots on. It's so weird. Like, I feel like they kept testing it and they're like, no, it's not happening. Maybe it's this one too. Some of those you can't use bots. It's like a couple of the snow ones. I think Snowblind's the only one you can. But we're gonna go Phoenix. Do we have Oddjob? Yes, we do have Oddjob. Gotta use Oddjob. No health handicap because we're not babies. How many? You get six, right? Yeah. Alright. So we're gonna go two guys on our team. We're gonna go Robocop. Fine. He's a little too good. He's honestly a little too good for our taste. Who else should we get? Jaws, I know, is pretty good. Is Knick-Knack good? Nah, Knick-Knack ain't that good. And then, here's how you set it up. We wish we had Bond in Spacesuit. Do we have Bond Tux? I don't think so. It's like each Bond is an upgrade. So we're gonna go Bond. And we're gonna upgrade his shit. Fast moving speed, personality. None. Aggression very high. Accuracy very good. Health 300. Reaction time 200. And recovery rate 50. That's how you fucking set up a bot. And now set up the rest of Y-Lin's, because Y-Lin's stats are already pretty fucking good. Look at that shit. Oh, and they're fixed. You can't even do anything about it. Okay. Well, yeah, we'll go the rest of Y-Lin's. I think the people that are actually from movies are fixed and you can't do it. Alright. Now, let's go. We'll go to 50. It sounds like a lot, but it's not going to take that long. Weapon set random. Dun, dun. Respawn near. Fix guns on. Explosive scenery. Okay, grapple, sure. No melee vehicles. Those are like, you can get in tanks and helicopters and stuff. Oddly enough, they don't have any in the main game, but they're not that great. They, like, you literally leave a body behind while you're controlling the remote control thing, so people just shoot you in the head. Industrial espionage. Oh, God. Oh, someone found a gun. Oh, Knick-Knack. It's -1 to -3. All right, maybe 50 might be a long shot here. All right, you might want to look this way, Bondi. This is crazy. The fucking explosives never... Oh my God! Almost got spawn killed by a grenade. All right, we gotta get someone with the hat. Oh, hey! We're still rocking that red hell from that one grenade that hit us. God. You know, this reminds me of Todd Ford shipment. Just fucking shut. You'll get someone. Okay, they're doing too bad. I can't let them just dip into the negatives. Sometimes that'll happen with bots. Maybe that's why they never did snow maps. They would just keep jumping into the pits. Oh, baby! Oh, this is some Phoenix base shit. This reminds me right when we were at this part. Oh, fuck. Alright, Knick-Knack, though, is, Kind of a dead weight, I gotta say. Fuck, Bond. You just shot that grenade in my mouth. Jesus. Oh my god. They're like two-shotting me with their automatics. Oh my god, I love watching them drop from the sky. Shit! Alright, I think we're tied up here. Oh my god, so many! Sorry, Nick-Nack! Where are they? Oh my god, they're right there. Shit. Man, they need to remaster this fucking game. Fuck. Oh my god, I shot you right in the head with a grenade. Alright, we can't lose this one. Fuck! Oh my god. But we're taking out Knick-Knack, like, every time. It's not helping when, like, we're getting team kills every time we're getting kills. Oh, Jesus. Fucking Bond is unreal, man. And if you think this Bond is crazy, Bond's spacesuit is a goddamn glitch. He, like, never dies. I think you have to get platinum on the last level to get Bond's spacesuit. Fuck! Oh my god. Nick-Nack is just flying all over the place. Oh my god. Fuck you! Alright, we need to make a comeback now. This is getting ugly. And by we, I mean pretty much me, because I don't even know what the fuck the computers are doing. Oh my god, Wyland, why do I have to shoot you in the head with a grenade launcher? Alright, we're within four. Oh, Jesus! God! Knick-Knack, please! I feel like RoboCop has the other six kills. Oh my god. Get him! Just get him! Use the grenade launcher, please! Oh my god. Alright, we're within three. Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, just launch it! Launch it like a football! No! Oh, you fuckers better not just die six times in a row. Fuck! No, I'm on burst! Oh, and I shot into Robo's back. Oh, it was burst. Oh, that was bad. Oh, no. No! We're getting destroyed! The Y-limbs are sticking together. No! Well, I definitely had the most. Yeah. Look at Bond, though. He had 27-9. Jesus. He had a better ratio than I did. Alright, well, that was some multiplayer. I didn't want to end it just on that little quick little Drake boss fight in the credits, but if you want to see some more multiplayer, let me know. I might do an episode or something with another man, but I think that's going to do it for Nightfire. I got my other GameCube playthrough ready. It's been a great time doing this one. As I said, this is absolutely in my top 10 games of all time. Love this game. Cannot get enough of this game. Thank you so much for spending your time watching this playthrough. I'll see you guys next time.